Hello, everyone. I'm really, really excited to be sharing this video with you of a painting in my Janus series that I made specifically to share with you guys. So as you guys may or may not know, my concept has to do a lot with the mysterious and not having access to information, which is why I put that white veil on. But to hold true with my concept, it means that I don't really share a lot of full behind the scenes work. So I don't know, it's sort of a bummer. So I made this piece to share everything with you as, so it can kind of serve as an example for everything else. So in the beginning, you've already seen me working with a rag instead of a brush. I really like working with rag, especially in the beginning. I think you're kind of able to keep things loose and keep myself free. And I have already used on the second layer those Sharpie paint pens. I am such a huge fan of them. I think they're so tough. The marks that I made, you can see in the very end, they're just really awesome. So most of my pieces, they don't start with any sort of a plan. So everything I do, every step I take, I kind of take a step back, plan the next step, and everything is inspired by that moment of mark making. It's a rubber scraper right there. I use a lot of different tools. I think I'm watching Friends here. So that's awesome. And the clouds take a lot of pulling at. So I will be kind of adding dark shades and adding light shades for a long time into the piece. More Sharpie paint pen. Even at this point when I'm making it, guys, I still don't really know what I'm going to mask out, and that helps me hold true to the concept. So I don't want to make a painting with the idea that I'm going to keep a certain area revealed. Otherwise, I think I sort of lose the integrity of the whole piece. Because the concept is that everything is created well and created equally, and then we start losing information. It's not made with the intention of sharing this amount, because then the rest of it could be garbage and you would never know. So I'm really working to make it as quality as I possibly can, and the entire thing as quality as I possibly can, and make the whole piece balanced. This session here is a little bit painful for me to watch because I made some marks that I didn't like, and then I spent a long time kind of recovering from it. So, I kept the camera rolling, but I was really aware that I had made a mistake and that I was going to have you watching it. So, ordinarily in the studio, mistakes happen and you just kind of roll with it. This was the first time I had made a weird mistake and knew that I was going to be sharing it with people. So, it recovers. Everything is sort of intentional and on purpose, and I can work with it, but I was really bummed. And there I am still trying to fix the mistake. So I have one brush that I use to do the veil. I don't use that particular brush for anything else, so I can keep it really clean and keep the brush from not being saturated by any other colors. But you know, with all that information on the bottom line of this, it takes a lot of paint. So that was one layer of it. I think it's usually three layers, so I don't think I filmed the third one because it's just repetitive. But it happened. It wasn't already enough work. Here's the embroidery, and I definitely cut out one of the sessions of filming this embroidery because there's just so much of it, and I feel like it's a little less interesting to watch because you can't really see it happening. But so then after it's finished, I'm matting in the embroidery. You have to hand punch everything first since it's paper. I don't want to damage my paper by trying to poke something through it. The paper is pretty tough. And here it is done.